Now, you need certain characteristics or certain skills to take on this position. And apparently at Offutt Kerman, they thought you had it. And that's why they asked you to do this. Because I would say, I don't see anything yet, but I would say you have to have good social skills. I mean, this is all about the hard facts about soft skills. You need those soft skills to be able to listen to people and not just broadcast who you are and the company you're working for. I'm assuming that's a given. Correct.
You took away my favorite sound bite. I was going to say soft skills is number one, because that has a place close to your heart, I think.
Absolutely. And that's why this is even called the hard facts about soft skills. If you don't have those soft skills, you're not going to excel in any aspect of your job personally.
That's true. And you know, for another conversation, it's debatable whether you can actually coach the soft skills and the social skills required to be a good business development manager.
Mm-hmm. So you're saying sometimes you just have it. Some people like to have it.
I mean, I think you have it. I think you can't teach it. Other people might disagree and think that you can teach it. Okay, well, I would say my top two or top four maybe. The first one I call one, but it's really two qualities, likable and trustable. Because we know that people do business with people they know, they like, they trust. And I add a fourth dimension, which is they need. Mm-hmm. So people could know me, like me, and trust me. But if they don't need me, Offutt Kerman is not getting hired, right? Interesting that if you just know and like someone, that doesn't mean you're going to do business with them. So the trust factor is huge. If the trust is there, you will do business with that person. So that's my top, likable and trustable. I'd say second on the list is persistence and patience, which are on different ends of the spectrum, you could say. So being persistent in my world means constantly dripping on your prospects and touching them with a newsletter, with an article, with an invitation to an event, et cetera. And patience, because at least in the legal industry, the sales cycle is somewhere around 18 to 24 months. So you really have to be patient. This is not like selling benefits or insurance or something that has a one-year anniversary or a defined anniversary, where you know if you just met with someone and they're 6 months into their new insurance plan, all you got is 6 months to wait and you're either in or out. So you really have to have a lot of patience, especially selling something with a long sales cycle. Other skills could be organizational skills, communication skills, we already mentioned, be curious, be interested, not interesting. I would say technical skills can be helpful. I don't really have great technical skills and I've done okay, but technical skills can be helpful. You gotta be willing to collaborate, be a problem solver. Having good business writing skills can be nice. I feel like I learned a long time ago how to write nice emails. So things like that, I would say, are very important. I would say one more thing would be willing to and understand that you need to provide value first. That's really important, that you go into a networking event, virtual or in person, and your whole head should be wrapped around who can I add value to and what does that look like? Who can I help? Don't go in thinking about yourself like who I can sell. It's who can I help? I would say those are important things. And if anybody ever has questions about my role and how to hire a good business development manager, experience to look for, skills, et cetera, I'd be happy to connect with them.